Hello friends, welcome to the official YouTube page of Everest IAS Academy. So today we are going to discuss December 29 Hindu newspaper analysis from the UPSC prelims 2020 point of view. So let's go into the video friends. So the first article which is very important is there is no extra charge on payments via RuPay card UPI from January 1. So from the new year they wanted to make this. So let's study this article in detail friends. So what this article is all about means basically they are discussing about the digital transactions which are made using RuPay card or like UPI when you make the scanning process. So what happens is that there will be usually an additional charge which will be charged. Hereafter the charge won't be levied. So further the government has given some directive regarding that. That is all the shops like establishments, business establishments and companies which have an annual turnover greater than 50 crore or more, they has to mandatorily offer that they will not charge this extra fees, that is the merchant discount rate. So let's first understand what is this merchant discount rate as MDR refers to. How it works means, suppose let's consider a case friend. Suppose you are going to a shop. So first in the shop you are swiping the card, so you are swiping the card for 100 rupees. Now what happens is that the bank will be normally charging like fees. That is suppose for an example, suppose it takes 1 rupees as the merchant discount rate. Then what happens is that finally that 99 rupees only will go on credit into the account of the shop or any petrol bank where you are doing this card swiping process. So where this extra 1 rupee, that 1 rupee which is lost, where it goes means it is usually, this is what we refer as MDR or merchant discount rate. So normally these 1 rupee is shared between the card issuing bank. So the customer, suppose he is from a Canara bank, so that bank will take some part of the amount and the remaining part will be shared between payment network, such as whether it is a MasterCard, Visa card or RuPay card, that gateway, that payment network will take it, and then the banks that provided the POS or swiping machine which the merchant is having, so it will be shared between these three people. So that is how this merchant discount rate works. So as of now what happens is that now the government wants to the merchant should not charge that extra fees, especially on the consumer. So what is the main objective the government is thinking means it will actually promote homegrown digital payment pathways will be promoted, so that many people will come forward and go for this paying by card process. So it will promote the digital pathways in the country. So the problem is one more thing is where this extra 1 rupees, who will charge means, so now that is the problem. So what this basically government has told is if a customer is generally not paying means, and merchant is also not paying, so some entity has to bear that extra MDR cost. In that either the bank has to bear or else the payment service providers, they has to bear that charge. But actually what these people are from the business side they are demanding means this extra risk should be borne by the government. That is the MDR rate which the government is asking them to waive off, that should be borne by the government, because it is the objective of the government to promote digital payments. Rather it will create an obligation or burden upon the payment service providers who are involved in the process. Friends, next article is test for unmanned mission by 2020 end. So basically we don't know much information regarding the Gaganyaan mission. As of you know only few facts regarding that we will discuss in this video friends. So basically our government wants to fly a unmanned test actually ahead of its manned mission, that is the Gaganyaan mission, which is a manned mission. So for in addition to that, what the ISRO is planning is that it is also in the process of planning for Chandrayaan 3 mission. Already Chandrayaan 2 has been launched and which we also discussed very detailedly in our videos also. So the Chandrayaan 2 consists of lander, rover and orbiter. But what happens is that in case of Chandrayaan 3, it will have only a rover and lander, rather that orbiter which is circling that moon, that will not be present. So that is the difference between Chandrayaan 3 and Chandrayaan 2. And as we know this Gaganyaan mission, it is a human space flight program. Friends, we should understand one thing is, as of now in the world if you see, only 3 countries have launched this space flight program very successfully. That is, first is Russia, then came USA, and then third one is China. Suppose when we become successful, we will have a huge command and respect in the international forum, since we are only in the fourth country in the world to go for this space flight mission. So that's why this project has also been considered to be a pet project of our honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji. So we are our ISRO is very much focusing upon this project, and it initially wants to test an unmanned mission like by sending a humanoid kind of thing. That is like, what is humanoid means? It will resemble like a human being, but the actual human being will not be present there. So in a robotic format they will send it, and they wanted to test it before they wanted to launch the actual humanoid mission. So basically it will consist of 3 member crew will be sent as part of the Gaganyaan mission. In addition to that, friends, this is launched as part of GSLV Mac-3. That is, it carries a load of 3.7 ton. So that is considered to be highest loading capacity in case of India, because GSLV Mac-3 can carry more loads compared to other space flights. That's why we are going to this GSLV mission. And in addition to that, what we need to know is that mission duration regarding this project is only for a week. That is, we are planned for 7 days program. What is the problem actually regarding this space flight mission? Why other countries are not more successful means? Friends, actually when we launch a rocket, what happens is that launching a rocket like whether through GSLV or PSLV, it's very easy. Because many countries have taken a lead in this. The main problem is when the space flight goes there and do some research, and when it comes back to the Earth, what happens is that that re-entry is only going to be the very challenging thing. Why? Because there will be a lot of friction will be there in the air. So it has to, the returning flight has to come and land safer. Suppose if the friction is not considered too much, means it may get a fire and it will blast in between only. That's why our ISRO is very much careful in studying this re-entry program, friends. So next article is China targets another American products, that is books in this case. So friends, as we know, there is a huge trade war which is happening between China and USA. So they are actually doing a trade war kind of scenario. So what they have targeted means they have targeted cars, beefs, soya beans, and now China has targeted the latest addition in that list is American books, in which the citizens of the Chinese people, they are very much actually interested in studying. They are voracious readers, friends. So they will read a lot of books, especially American author books, which the Chinese government is not promoting now. So friends, from the preliminary point of view, which we need to understand is only the trade war definition, which we need to know there is a chance for them to ask. So trade war means nothing but a protectionist kind of measure, but here there will be extremistic protectionism will happen. So what will happen means both the countries will go on increase their tariffs, taxes on the import, taxes on the products which the government is going to import from other countries. And in addition to that, they will also create some other trade barriers, maybe in the form of quotas. They will not allow too much products to enter in their market condition. So what happens is that under such a condition of increased protectionism, their country will move towards the objective of self-sufficiency, which we can refer to a pre-globalized world only. We were very much focused upon self-sufficiency. That is, they will produce, each country will produce the goods for their own market rather than concentrating upon the other countries. So this trade war like phenomenon, which is extreme protectionism measure, may land up somewhere in the future towards a pre-globalized world. So that's why it's looked upon a very dangerous move, and these both the countries are now taking step, friends, to solve this issue. Next article is reforms restored PSB health. So basically what our finance minister has made a statement means now as of now 13 banks in the PSBs have which has listed losses in the previous year. Now they have turned to profitability, and they have also reduced the non-performing assets to 18%. Friends, we have discussed much more in detail this non-performing assets concept in yesterday's and day before yesterday's video also. So those of the friends who have missed that, so kindly refer that video also. So let's go and discuss this issue. Here basically what these people from the PSB, heads of the PSB banks, what they told means public sector banks, there is an undue harassment, so much harassment these enforcement agencies, especially CBI, CVC, they are doing. Because after NPA problem, what happened, the main flaw which the other people found is bank went on lending, it was went in a lending spree without taking into the proper documents. So finally they didn't get their loans also on time. So that's why it went to a non-performing asset scenario where the principal or interest has not been paid for 3 months. So that is 90 days. So in this case, we call it as non-performing asset. So now what happens is that even a genuine decision cannot be made by the PSB banks for promoting the or in boosting the investment condition in the country. That's why these PSB banks chiefs have complained to the finance minister, and even the finance minister has said that the chief, like CBI, which is Central Bureau of Investigation, it will not take any own action on its own unless and until if there is any referral is made by the Internal Banking Vigilance Committee, that is a scam are happening, any bad decision they have made, then only CBI will come and interfere. That's what our finance minister has said. But what these banking people are much more worried about is there is so much harassment happening, and officials who are working in the banking sector, only they are not that much confident enough to make even a genuine loan making decisions. That's why it's preventing them from lending from the bank side, and the business climate is totally affected in the country. That is the CBI, CVC and CAG. So they all are actually creating harassment. That's what banking people have reported to the finance minister. In addition to that, from the preliminary point of view, this term, kindly remember friends, that is e-Bakraya, that is nothing but a common e-auction platform to sell all the properties which has been collected or attached as part of these NPA problems, that they wanted to sell it via online. So through an auctioning process, that is why we call it as e-Bakraya. So next article is bank deposit cover set for increase. Basically here, from the preliminary point of view, we should understand this deposit insurance credit guarantee operation. So basically what it does is it will provide insurance to the deposits which are happening in the banks. So what happened is that insurance will happen only for the deposits only up to 1 lakh. So those deposits include saving deposits, fixed, current account, RD deposits, everything, only up to 1 lakh for each deposits in a bank. So now the government, because of the various problems happening in the country, wants to increase this insurance limit between 3 lakh to 5 lakh, and even this body, that is the deposit insurance credit guarantee corporation, has also agreed regarding that. And it is, this is nothing but an subsidiary under RBI only, friends. This is very important, kindly remember it. It was even set up in 1978 only. That objective has been to provide insurance to the deposits and even guaranteeing the credit facilities, what the banks are doing. So next article is the economy in really a bad shape? Of course, yes. As we know already, friends, we have discussed a lot. As we have discussed two important articles in this week only. One was written by renowned economist C. Rangarajan, and another article has been written by the famous artist economist Arun Kumar. So we have discussed both the things. So according to their author's opinion, what they said, Rangarajan has said that the only thing what the government should do in the immediate terms is it should concentrate on the financial sector reforms. And what happened is that in addition to that, they have told that government can go for narrow breaching of the fiscal deficit, and it should go and lend or make some new fresh investments, and that will especially in the unorganized sector, so that it will boost the business climate in the country and the growth can be promoted. That's what these renowned economists have suggested a solution. And as we know that as part of this article, they are telling that the quarterly economic growth, it has fallen to 4.5%, which is considered to be very, very low, at least for the 5-6 years in our history of Indian economy. As part of that, our government has initially slashed the corporate taxes which the business will be paying from 30% to 22%, and even it has made 15% for newly startup companies which have started after September 2019. So in addition, they are telling that this, from this article, like the slowdown is not structural, rather it is cyclical. So cyclical means nothing but in a cyclical form, so when the slowdown is happening, when the revival happens, means it will come back to its normalcy. But if there is any structural problem, means we have to go for structural reforms, that is GST and GST is considered to be one of the structural reforms. Like that, we should go for lot of financial sector reforms. But as of now, we should not be too much worried, because the growth is cyclical. That's what even various experts have told. So cyclical problem will come on its and revive on its own, but the government should go and take some initiative. That's what this article is all about. So next article is, what is the direct on detention centers? Friends, basically, this detention center concept arises due to this NPR registry, which the government is going to conduct between April and September. But where the problem lies means, even though the government has said that they are not going to link NPR with NRC, that is, NPR means nothing but the usual residents of the country, and that residence includes even foreigners also. Any residents who stay in an area for the last 6 months and they intends to stay for another 6 months, they will be registered as part of this registry. So there, it is a collection of registry, but NRC based upon a cutoff date, that is December 31st 2014, as of as per the Citizenship Amendment Bill, it will try to identify who are the citizens of the country and who are the illegal migrants. Now the problem is, once they are identified as illegal migrants, they will be asked to prove their identification that they are the citizens of the country. Here there is a discriminatory provision under the Citizenship Amendment Bill where Muslims cannot come and claim citizenship status because it is considered to be discriminatory. It includes only non-Muslim communities from three neighboring countries, Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh. So that's why people are protesting across the country. But as part of this NPR registry, our government is collecting additional details like other details, like the place of birth of the father and mother, their citizenship status, driving license numbers. All are considered to be actually the data which are very much required for the NRC registry. That's why the people are very much vigilant about, and they are actually protesting. The government is indirectly doing an NRC exercise to identify the citizens. So now the problem what happens is that so there is no new laws, even there is nothing new, anything is needed, laws or rules to conduct the NRC exercise. So government can anyhow do on its own through executive decision. So that's why the fear climate is happening in the country. And in addition to that, the problem is when they are considered as an illegal migrants, they will be sent to the foreigners tribunal, as that's what happened in case of as part of NRC exercise which was conducted in Assam this year, where illegal migrants around 19 lakhs people were identified. And now they don't know what will happen to their citizenship status in future. So they may be now sent to, like if they don't prove their citizenship status before the foreigners tribunal, they may be sent to the detention centers. This is where the problem is. Once they are sent to the detention center, they will be treated as an alien and illegal migrants. And in addition to that, there was one more detention center concept that was under the section 32C of the Foreigners Act. Those who violate, foreigners who came to India who are violating their visa conditions and extending their stay beyond the time permitted, they will be sent back to the detention center. That is one separate detention center, but this detention center is happens as part of this NRC exercise in Assam. That's why people are afraid in future whether they will be sent to the detention center. Means even genuine citizenship may be, if they don't have the proper documents with them, it will actually be discriminated to them. That's why the people are worried. Next article is, need a different approach to address child malnutrition. Friends, basically what this article is basically talking about, child malnutrition, and they are saying in India decline has happened, but the rate of decline is very slow. That is why this article is very important. Friends, kindly note, this article is very, very, very important for the mains perspective, where malnutrition is forms a part of the syllabus itself. So kindly collect all the facts which are given in this article, which you can use for the mains examination. So there are five important malnutrition concepts or indicators, that is stunting, underweight. Underweight is low weight, and there is another one is called low birth weight, and then wasting, and then anemia. Anemia means lack of iron deficiency. So let's go and understand this basic indicators concept for the preliminary perspective in the video. So from friends, one more thing is, this National Family Health Survey, which has conducted the survey in 2015 to 16, it has said that the high prevalent was regarding the anemia was prevalent in the poorest of the poor areas in Rajasthan, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Telangana. These are considered to be part of Bimaru states, and there has not been any improvement in the child malnutrition status. That's what this author is saying. And one more thing, friends, we would have studied already, but for your revision I am saying this. Malnutrition refers to undernutrition, taking less nutrition, or even overnutrition is also included. Taking too much nutrition is also referred as malnutrition. Not only always less, it includes even more nutrition also. So kindly remember this, friends. And you can suppose take this exam. This is the normal height of the person and this is his actual weight. So what happens is that he is having the normal height, but in his side he is having a less weight, means it is counted as wasted condition. And suppose a person is having less height and weight is normal, then we call it as stunted condition. This is the concept, friends. So next article is shape of sun's corona accurately predicted. Basically here our scientists from India, especially Center for Excellence in Space Sciences from Kolkata, during the solar annual solar eclipse which happened 2-3 days before, they have actually studied the shape of the corona of the outermost part of the sun's atmosphere. We will try to see these parts of corona in our video also. Basically it is nothing but the external part of the atmosphere of the sun, that is corona. It is in a state of plasma. Friends, we know there are 5 states of matter. One is solid, liquid, gas, and the 4th state is plasma. 5th state of matter is Einstein Bose condensation, that was created during the time of Higgs boson test. So what happens is that in the corona, inner corona will be in a yellow color, outer corona will be in a whitish color, and it extends into space. Friends, in this picture you can clearly see that, see friends, this center part, which is where the all the ionized radiations are coming, we call it as core, and the outer radius, this is a radiative layer, and then this external outermost layer, that only we call it as corona. Friends, it consists of inner corona, which is yellowish in color, and outer corona will be whitish in color, and it extends into human space also. Friends, kindly subscribe to our channel. If you have any doubts, please post your doubts in the comment section.